Composites are made up of two different materials and they're combined. And the idea here is to take two materials, material A and material B, put them together in such a way that the combination of the property that results as a consequence of putting these two materials together has a characteristic or property which is better than the individuals by themselves. There are numerous structural applications. The types of applications where we generally see these material is when we're talking about or we're considering structures that are rigid, structures where we need high strength, and structures that are low in density, where the density becomes a critical factor. Now, there are a variety of different materials that we see in our engineering world. Materials like aluminum mixed with silicon carbide. As we know, aluminum is a metallic material. It is a relatively ductile material, and when we take that material and we include in the material silicon carbide, which tends to be very small fibers, those fibers wind up imparting a elastic modulus contribution to the aluminum. As we increase the amount of silicon carbide, we wind up increasing the elastic modulus of aluminum and make it a stiffer material than it is otherwise when silicon carbide is not present. There are a variety of different types of polymeric composites, which are carbon-carbon, carbon-epoxy, and plywood. Steel-belted radials represent another composite material. Rather than being at a microscopic level, it's at a much more macroscopic level. The last that I have on this list is reinforced concrete. And reinforced concrete is made up of individuals of materials, a steel material and a concrete material. Everywhere you look in terms of structural materials, buildings, roadways, and roadbeds, there is a large amount of pre-stressed concrete that's being used. Again, it is a two-material unit. We take steel rods or cables of steel, apply tension, and of course the thing about the steel is that it is metallic in nature, and of course you can deform it. And so what is done then is by tightening down on those end caps, what we do then is to put the steel cable or rod into a state of tension. Then with that rod in tension, we then wind up casting around it the concrete. And of course, when we look at those two individual parts, the metal rod is of course a ductile material and is very good in tension, which is the reason that we can pull it. Secondly, the concrete is very good in compression, which is a characteristic of ceramic type materials, which concrete is. And when we, after the material has been cast and the concrete has set, and we separate the concrete slab from its assembly, as soon as the end caps of the metal rod are cut, the material bends a bit, as illustrated by that red insert into the concrete, and that then winds up contributing to the important characteristic of a pre-stressed concrete roadbed. Let's consider then what happens when the material is used in an application. Over to the right, we have unloaded material. The one at the top is a beam, and the one below it is a beam in which the material has undergone a shape change, like the shape change that's occurred at that bottom lower section highlighted by red. Now we turn to the right, and if we look at the beam that was initially flat and we apply a load to it, what we find is the very end, the lower portion of that beam is in a state of tension. Now, below that, what we see is what happens when we apply a load to the bed which has that curvature to it. And what then occurs is, as a consequence of that top load, the state of stress on that lower concrete surface, rather than being in tension, is now in compression. So what we've done is to utilize the good qualities of the metallic materials, the excellent qualities of concrete, and produce the structure whose combination is better than those that are made up individually. We have been focusing on one type of characteristic in all of these individual examples of metals, ceramics, polymers, and composites. In the next section, I want to describe something that we refer to as correlated properties. So rather than thinking about an individual property, we're interested in considering properties that are correlated with respect to one another. And the one that we will be providing some examples for is the idea of strength and ductility.